once again, another sounder. This is kind of the Wednesday warning. Yes, that means the work week is just about half done. And we're going to try and say, well, what have we done so far that's made it worthwhile? And what are we going to do tomorrow? You know, Thursday is oftentimes what I say, turbulent Thursday. That's when you've got to do some difficult stuff, and perhaps you're going to have to endure some difficulties. At least be prepared for it. So when it comes to Friday, it's a future Friday, and you're going to plan for the future, not think about the past. Remember that. On Friday, you plan for the future. You don't think about the past. Well, today I'm going to talk about something someone shared with me, and it was called the 5-second rule. Have you heard about that? Well, I'm just learning about it, and I thought I'd take a few minutes for some of you to hear me out, and perhaps you can help me with the 5-second rule. This is an interesting idea, and the program begins right now. And we're back for a few minutes. Now remember, I'm suggesting that every day, throughout the day, again, as I oftentimes say, say thank you 100 times a day. Say thank you 100 times a day to somebody, something. Say thank you. Just do it. Also, right now, I have that one-word prayer or affirmation, or give it any term you want. But it's that word, Issachar, which describes a group of people who understand the times and know what to do. Understand the times and know what to do. And that's something that I'm seeking in life, and I'd like to help you seek it too. You figure out, as I often say, that great consultant Bugs Bunny had the question, what's up? What's up, Doc? What's going on in your life? How are you? How are you? What's going on? How can I help you? What's up, Doc? So, in effect, I want you to remember that Issachar, 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 understanding the times, and then, even more important, what to do. All right? Her name is Mel, and some of you have probably heard of her. Mel Robbins. I'd never heard of her, but someone suggested the 5-second rule. So I went in and looked it up, and I'd never heard about her because I'm really not much of a pop culture kind of guy. And she is a remarkable woman. She has written a number of very fine books, and she has literally a worldwide following on the internet and on YouTube and on podcasting, which is a rule you must note. You may never, and I certainly may never be as make it as Mel Robbins is, but she knows one of the secrets, and that is today, if you want to be a person of influence, you're going to have to not only perhaps write a book, but you're going to have to learn how to use exactly what I'm doing right now. You're going to have to do what it takes to be on the radio, to be on the audio networks, to be on the video. You have to take the digital world, and you have to platform yourself on the digital platforms. That's what it takes radio, witradio.net, witradio.net. That's what we help you and your business do. And you're going to have to do it someday, so you might as well start now. And according to my friend, she would say, you just had an idea, an instinct. And Mel said, that means within 5 seconds, you should make a move. In 5 seconds, you should make a move. Now, that's all I understand right now. But I'm going to read the book and perhaps listen to it, which is more important. I prefer to listen to someone like her rather than read her, because I want to see her energy and her personality. I want to experience her performance as well as her product. And that's a better thing to do. And that'll give me a simple idea of whether I really want to invest the $20 to buy the book. Remember that. Just remember that. That's very important. Demonstrate how good you are. Don't just describe what you do. Now, I'm going to add one thing to it. Oftentimes I say 5 seconds from Mark. I've used that word term for years. And what that means is I'm getting ready to record a program with a guest. And I'm telling them, and the expression I used to use was tapes rolling, which shows how old I am. That meant that the tape, you know, the reel of recording tape, we had turned it on and it's now rolling. And so we're ready to record the program. So we would say, tapes rolling, 5 seconds from mark. And then everybody would count to five quietly, which meant for there was going to be a 5 second gap in the program. And then the person who's going to start the program starts talking. And that gives us a shut up, be quiet, get ready. We're going to bat off. We're going to do it. And you get ready. And then there's a bit of a help to the producer because he knows that in that 5 second gap, the program is going to begin where he has to start doing his editing and producing work right then. 5 seconds from mark. And you start the program. I'd heard about that. Here's what I'm wondering. I would very much say, and I oftentimes say this, you have 7 seconds to get a person's attention. That's an old radio rule. It's even more rule today. 5 second pause will be good because you can even use some dead air to get people to pay attention. Oh, what's going on? 7 seconds, that's the maximum of dead air. However, in effect, I would simply say is you have to, within 5 to 7 seconds, don't just make a move, say something, pray something, say something. Pick up your smartphone and start talking and recording something. Say something. Always be ready to take an instinct or an idea and see if you can give it a word or an expression. That's what will stick in your mind. And in case you can't remember it, don't worry. You recorded it. You can go back. In fact, that has been one of the ways that I've always tried. Whenever I get a good idea for the radio program, I used to just record it. If I have a notebook, and I always have a notebook, I might write it down. Write it down. That's a movement. And speak it. And I believe that it's important that whenever good ideas come to you, stop, look, speak. That's my 5 seconds. I hope it might be helpful to you. I'd love to hear what you know about the 5 second rule. Please write to me at stanhouston@gmail.com. stanhouston@gmail.com. And of course, I want to get you on the radio. I want to help change your life. And she says the 5 second rule can change your life. Let me say this. If you become a podcaster, it will change your life. It's not easy, but I can help you do it. If you will start podcasting, it will change your life. Now, you may not get rich and famous, but it will change your life. And I can guarantee that if you follow it through, if you follow it through, if you follow it through, if you keep moving and keep speaking. I can help you in your life, in your business. My name is Stan Houston. I've been doing this for many, many years. I'm old. I'm not gray because I've shaved my head, so you can't tell. But I am. But I've had lots of experiences. I've had many tragedies. I've had many mysteries. And I've had a number of victories. And I've had a number of challenges that I've had to overcome, including about 3 or 4 that I'm working on right now. But I'm not afraid. I've come through so much before, I know I can probably come through what's in my life right now. And I know that you can too. We need one another, and we need not only one another, we need the other. And if you don't know who the other is, I'll be happy to tell you. Once again, my name is Stan Houston. These are interesting ideas. I trust that you will come back again, and that you will stay in touch, and that you will create and come forward with more interesting ideas. Best and blessings to you, and bye for now.